friends, you're welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, thank you so much for stopping by. And to my returning subscribers, I want to tell you that you guys are really amazing. Thank you so much for supporting me. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to prepare this healthy, delicious drink. It is called zobo drink in Nigeria, and it is generally known as hibiscus tea. So I'll be showing you step by step on how you are going to get this done. And the first thing I'll be needing to prepare this drink is pineapple. I'll be needing the pineapple peel and not the pineapple itself. The next thing I will be needing in preparing this tea is the hibiscus flower itself, that is zobo. Zobo is packed with antioxidants. Hibiscus tea is rich in powerful antioxidants and may therefore help prevent damage and diseases caused by the buildup of free radicals. In one study in rats, hibiscus extract increased the number of antioxidant enzymes and reduced the harmful effect of free radicals by up to 92%. So the first thing I'm going to do is that I'm going to add my hibiscus into a bowl, and I'm going to wash it. I'll pick it first, then I'm going to wash it very clean. If you are washing it, you will notice that red color will be something like that. Red color will be coming out of it. Don't be, you know, discouraged. It's normal. It's nothing compared to what you're going to get when you have boiled the flour itself. So I'm going to add it to, I've finished washing, I'm going to add it to the pot I'm going to use to boil the tea. So you see the water is really red, and you will start thinking that maybe you might have washed the nutrients away. No, do not worry, because you have something bigger than that. So the next thing I'm going to do is that I'm going to wash my pineapple tea. Because I'll be needing the peels, I'm just going to grab my sponge to, in order to wash it very clean, because I won't be throwing away the peels. So I have to wash it very clean. So because I'm going to need the peel, I'm going to wash it very clean. The skin of pineapple is said to have to contain bromelain, which is a powerful enzyme, anti-inflammatory in nature. It can be used to reduce swelling post-surgery or an injury. It is also believed to help with digestion. It is said the peel can fight intestinal parasites and help with constipation. I'm just going to grab my knife and begin to peel off the pineapple. I'm also going to add them inside the pot where I added my zobo leaves or zobo flower. The next thing I'm going to be needing here is clove. As a spice, clove confers significant nutritional benefits. According to the nutrition data, 1 teaspoon of ground clove contains 30 pieces of the RDI of the mineral manganese, 4% of the RDI of vitamin K, 3% of the RDI of vitamin C, and 3 amounts of calcium, magnesium, and vitamin A. It is also a good source of fiber. So now I'm going to have added water to my mixture. The next thing I'm going to do right now is to add it, is to start boiling. I'm going to put it on a high heat. I'm going to boil, or I'll leave it on a high heat until it starts boiling. Then I'll turn down the heat and boil it for 10 minutes on a low heat. So just boil it to an extent, avoid it, turn down the light. Look at how it is, guys. The tea is coming out. So that's my grinded clove. I'm going to add it, then I'll continue boiling. I need the clove to be boiled as well. That's why I am adding it at this point. So I'm going to cover it up and continue boiling, but now it's on a high heat. It's done. It's 10 minutes since it started boiling, and it's time to turn down the heat, and I'm going to let it settle for some time. So after like 1 hour, here I am. I'm going to separate the chaff, the leaf and the pineapple peel from the main drink, from the main tea. So now I'm done with the pineapple peel, so I'll start with the zobo leaf. So I'm done removing the hibiscus flower from the pot, and that is how it looks. It's kind of very thick. The next thing I'm going to add here is mango flavor. This is actually optional. If you don't want to add flavor to it, it's fine, but I just want to add this flavor to it. I'm not going to add sugar, so the amount of the flavor you're going to add depends on the amount of zobo you are making. Right now mine is 3 liters, so I added 2 sachets of mango flavor. So now I'm going to do the final sieving before transferring to my container. Like, thank you so much for watching. Love you.